This is Muhammad Ali at the Live Shop from Cleveland. Here on Wide World, we'll be going there very soon. A live coverage of results in golf. My man Howard Cosell is in Cleveland, Ohio. So why don't we go there now live and hear what Howard has to say.
Thank you very much, Chris. We're coming to you live from the Cleveland Coliseum in a suburb of Cleveland, Richfield, Ohio. And we're bringing you the weigh-in for the heavyweight championship fight, which will be held here tomorrow night. Muhammad Ali against Chuck Wepner. As you can see, Chuck Wepner is now coming out from his dressing room and moving into the Coliseum area itself. He'll be coming up here to be weighed in. The gentleman weighing him in will be a former middleweight fighter named Ron Delaney. Calls himself the Irish middleweight. You remember Ron Delaney, the great mile runner from Dublin, who came over and starred at Villanova some long years ago. A remarkable miler in his time, even though Ron doesn't pretend that he was a remarkable middleweight in his time. Chuck Wepner, who's been mocked, sneered at, ridiculed. They talk about him as the Bayonne bleeder. But a man who's comported himself as a gentleman in the preparations leading up to this fight and the training. And a man who, in a strange way, has his own impossible dream. Says he's been dreaming every night that he'll knock Muhammad Ali out in the 13th round. Doesn't seem remotely possible. Nobody believes that it is. But in 1935, there was the Cinderella Kid, Jim Braddock, who upset Max Baron 15 rounds. In 36, an untitled bout at Yankee Stadium, Max Schmeling KO'd Joe Louis in the 12th round. Walcott beat Charles, and Muhammad Ali, when he was Cassius Marcellus Clay, actually stunned the world in 64 at Miami Beach when Sonny Liston sat in the stool and relinquished the heavyweight title. Now it's Chuck Wepner with his impossible dream getting ready to step on the scales. Scales are being prepared. How are you, Chuck? Good to see you. Good luck to you, my friend. You appear to be in real trim. You ready to weigh him, Ron? Let's go ahead with the weigh-in. Chuck Wepner moving on to the scales. A big man, a tall man. Might make Muhammad Ali have to hit upward, which Ali doesn't necessarily like to do.
Now, 225
is the weight of Chuck Wepner. Chuck, come on over here. We're going to use this camera, if you will. Chuck, I've been talking about your own dream, the one where you KO Ali in the 13th round every night. How did that initiate?
Well, I just I went to sleep one night, Howard, and I started dreaming, and it came about. And you're jumping up and down, and you're yelling, "I don't believe it, I don't believe it." And I come over and I say, "Believe it, Howard, because there he is." You know, you got to be in the dream. You're the main man.
Well, you're very kind, Chuck. But, Chuck, more importantly, the tactic. Ali, if he uses the ropes as he did against Foreman in Zaire, how will you counteract that?
Well, we'll move in right on top of him, Howard. We'll fight him at close quarters right on top of him. We won't flail away like George did. George made a mistake and punched himself out. He wasn't in condition. And that's the difference, condition. When you're not in condition, you can't do that. You get tired after three or four rounds. When you're in condition, you can go to root. I'm in condition.
Mm-hmm. Now, Chuck, many people have referred to your epidermis, your skin. Talked about you as the Bayonne bleeder. You've had surgery, and actually your skin looks remarkably good now. Have you been bleeding at all?
Well, we've had a few small cuts in the last 3.5 years, but no more than 2 stitches in one cut. And we've never had a fight stopped or lost a fight in the last 3.5 years. So I guess the skin surgery worked wonders. And I don't worry about cuts anymore in fights.
All right, Chuck. Ali says he's not in shape. Says it frankly. Says, in effect, that you're a cinch opponent. Your reaction?
Well, I want him to say that. And I want him to think that. Because tomorrow night he's going to lose his crown if he comes in out of shape.
Well, good luck to you. I wouldn't want your job, but God bless you and good luck to you.
Thank you very much.
Chuck Wepner, in a moment. Applause for the challenger as he goes out. In a moment, we'll be talking with Muhammad Ali as he comes up here. But right now, let's depart for a commercial moment, and we'll be back in the Cleveland Coliseum live in just a moment.
You should get...
We're back live at the Cleveland Coliseum. Perhaps you're seeing the Idafor screen in this great new arena, only a few months old. And Ali, well, Ali is now going through an old movie. This is a rerun, as he is apparently coming up to this platform to be weighed in. Originally, there were words that Pete Rademacher was supposed to referee this bout. I spoke with Pete earlier. He said he didn't know. And now, apparently, the referee of the bout will be Tony Perez. Though, don't take that official as official until the commission makes its announcement. Ali, in a scene you've witnessed so very, very often. Carrying on, the arm outstretched, the preachments recurrent. This is the heavyweight champion of the world. You will find him overweight and, by his own admission, not in shape. The exact weight to be determined in just a moment. But he captures the crowd as he always does, the cynosure of all eyes. No hungry generations, in the words of John Keats, tread this man down. Come on, Muhammad. Yes, Ali is screaming. You can see that this is serious business.
All tumble, you boy.
All right, Ali is done with this part of his recurrent act.
I'm fat. You heard all about how fat I am? I'm out of shape, and don't touch me. You've been jiving with me for a long time. I've been wanting to put an end to you. One of these days, I'm going to pull your hair out.
All right. Get on the scale. Let's
I'll
check
get on
your
the
weight.
Scale. And tell everybody how fat Muhammad Ali is. The other day you were telling me about I'm the greatest of all time, one of what former. It ain't been but a few months. Now you're going to criticize me about how big and fat I am. I thought I was the greatest. I thought some George Foreman didn't.
On the scale, Muhammad. There we go. All right, we've had that act.
Yeah, it was an act. I heard that crack. We had that act. Damn it, you think I'm acting? Be here tonight, Muhammad.
I'll be here.
Man, get back, man. Damn it, get back.
Drew Brown Bundy.
Yeah.
Go and get the true weight, though.
Man's in trouble.
Ron Delaney, why does the man fix his own weight?
Because I am boxing. I'm not the champion. I'm not just a fighter. He's challenging boxing. Is this thing on TV?
If you're on live, Mom. This is Ron Delaney representing the commission.
Don't put your hands on me, Shonda. I didn't know you were commissioned,
that's
man.
That's right. That's real,
I just figured you was another brother. I don't know. We got Red Fox here. I can't lose. James Byrne is here. Billy Epstein is here. Pop Staples is here. Staples singers. I cannot lose with all that soul.
All right, what was the weight? Ron Delaney. Ron Delaney, the official weight, please.
You have serious problems.
Excuse me. The official weight for Muhammad Ali was 223 and a half.
223 and a half. The official weight for Muhammad Ali. The heaviest he ever came in was against Mac Foster in Tokyo, Japan. He was 229 pounds for that one. He's more than 6 pounds over what he was for George Foreman. Here it is. Ali, the heaviest he ever came in was against Mac Foster in Tokyo, Japan. He was 229 pounds for that one. He's more than 6 pounds over what he was for George Foreman. Here it is. The same old scene. The pretension of animosity. All right, come on in for a quick comment. Come on, I've got... Quick comment. There's the camera.
Oh, it's Bill calling me a nigger.
All right.
You be ringside, you hear me? You wasn't inside here. You were smart. You stayed out of the way because we were going to do something to you.
We'll be back in just a moment. Muhammad Ali carrying on in his usual vein. Same old act. We're back at the Cleveland Coliseum live. Muhammad Ali carrying
right
on Chuck Wepner left.
Right in
all right, gentlemen.
Don't touch me.
Enough.
Right in your nose.
Enough's enough. Let's go.
What do you mean,
Chuck,
enough?
How do you react to all of this?
He's nuts. He's a psycho kid. What can I tell you? There's something definitely wrong with him.
The other day you were quoted as saying, I'm sick of the guy. He's trying to make a fool of me.
Well... I tell you, the guy's a great fighter, but we're going to beat him tomorrow night.
Yeah. I'm the greatest of all time.
Yeah, but he's a better talker.
And you're going to be in trouble when you see this crowd and these lights, and when you meet Muhammad Ali, you're going to ask yourself, why am I here?
nervous wreck. Look at me. I'm sweating
you
and everything.
You're a nervous wreck?
Yeah, I'm a nervous wreck.
You'll be here tomorrow. Keep talking. What you going to do? Tell the people. Don't get scared because you're on television. What are you going to do?
I'm going to whip you. I'm going to surround you and whip you.
You're going to whip me? What about picking me up and throwing me out of the ring? You're going to throw me out of the ring?
Right, I might throw you out of the ring into the second row.
You really looking for trouble, ain't you?
Yeah, I know, I am.
You really want trouble.
I'm going to mess up that pretty face.
You're going to mess up my face.
Yeah, that's right.
What you mean, that's right?
That's right.
That's right.
That's right.
What you mean?
Red wants to get out of here. Red wants to
see you tomorrow. Where's Red Fox?
This is what you would call old world tough stuffing.
And about
between the champion and one of the biggest long shots in the history of boxing. All right, now, quiet for a minute. Quiet. All right. All right. Muhammad, come back here. I need him one more minute.
Ali. One more minute.
I also want Angelo Dundee. Yes. Angelo Dundee, Muhammad's trainer. Angie, originally the thought was that Pete Radomack, the one-time amateur champion who fought Floyd Patterson in 57, would be the referee of this fight. It develops that he's withdrawn. You handled him, didn't you?
I worked with Pete Rademacher. He was a great fighter, and he fought Patterson's first professional fight. And I worked with Pete when he defeated George Chavallo. He's a real good fighter and a real good commissioner.
Well, he is withdrawn because of any possible partiality on his part to your fighter because of his prior relationship with you.
Well, I think Pete is being a heck of a man saying that and admitting we were together.
All right, champ, you've been doing all the talking. You've done all of your tough thumping live on television.
Is it live?
What round will you knock him out?
You always, I'm not calling around. I want to say one thing while we live, and you can't erase this. You always said, Muhammad, you're not the man you were 10 years ago, right?
Right.
Well, I'm going to ask your wife, are you the man you was last year?
You'll get a quick answer to that. Yes, Ron. Come on in here, Ron Delaney.
Will really be a correction on the selection of the referee?
Yeah.
I was, engaged to take care of the weigh-in, but I also knew about the conversation about the change in the referee. Now, both camps did not want Pete Rademacher as the referee.
Neither camp did.
Neither camp.
Why not the
There were incidentals. It's like Muhammad Ali said that he had poor contact with him at some other time.
So it'll be Tony Perez.
Tony Perez has been the
right.
one that...
Ron, thank,
camps
thank you for clarifying it for us. All right, Chuck. I think we're about ready to release you now, Chuck. Again,
why don't you say hello to my manager?
All right.
Al Braverman.
Nice to meet you.
And Patty Fuzz. Patty, how are you?
Patty Fuzz.
Red Fox. Come on in here, Mr. Sanford.
Sorry, let me go, Harry.
What do you think of this kind of exhibition? Pretty absurd, isn't it?
Oh, it is. It is. It's a good part for a new series.
All right. That's the story in the Cleveland Coliseum where we've been coming to you live in another one of those Muhammad Ali scenes that you've read about so often. Ali coming in at 223.5. Don King, the promoter here with me, who is apparently now a major factor in Ali's future, exercising as he does some considerable influence with the champion and with Herbert Muhammad. Do you feel happy about the kind of scene we've just witnessed? Don't you think it's a little old hat?
No, I don't, Howard. I'm just jubilant. I feel very proud to have it here in my hometown of Cleveland, Ohio. I love my town, and my people, I think, are fantastic. And this is really the pinnacle. I think it's the ultimate of human gratification to bring a world title event to this great city of Cleveland, the great state of Ohio.
Okay, Don. Thank you very much.
Me and you.
I see Commissioner Sherwood of the New York State Boxing Commission has just come up here. Your view of the proceedings, Commissioner.
I enjoyed it. I enjoyed being in Cleveland. I enjoyed being here with my friend Don King, the promoter. And I enjoyed the challenger and the champions participation.
As a boxing commissioner, do you approve of the Ali antics? They're kind of like a movie rerun now.
I think it's good for boxing. I think Muhammad kind of spurs his opponent on, and I think the public will be well served.
Okay, Commissioner, thank you. Good to see you again, sir. And so Commissioner Sherwood takes his departure, and Don King, the promoter of the bout, is going to be leaving us up here on the platform right next to the official scales, where Ali weighed in at 223.5 and where Wepner weighed in at 225.
As for my own view of this fight tomorrow night, as you all know, Wepner is one of the longest shots in boxing history. There have been other great, great upsets in the heavyweight division. Ali is not in good shape. There is that punch in the belly. But at the same time, while I don't think he will look good in beating Wepner tomorrow night, he most assuredly, in my judgment, will defeat Chuck Wepner. And I suspect we'll see a lot of the blood come out of Wepner's skin, as in the days before the surgery that he referred to in his conversation with me. He may again become the Bayonne bleeder, the only man ever in boxing to bleed more than Henry Cooper of Great Britain, who became a kind of test tube case in that regard. Now, back to Chris Shenkin.